Greetings, our Hebrew Israelite brothers and sisters. This is L.D. Smith, the watchman on the wall. Israel, it is our Sabbath. Would you kindly grab that King James? First and foremost, we here at LieToMeNoMore.org, we want to wish all of our sisters and brothers a happy Sabbath. Now, that being said, going forward here, most of you guys know that has been following us that our primary goal is to disprove Jesus every Sabbath. All right, now let us go forward tonight in our teaching. We'll be coming from the book of 1 John. And tonight, my sister and brother, I ask you, just think about the wording that when you read and just listen to it, and you'll find out tonight that, as you always do, this is some of the craziest stuff in the New Testament. All right, now going forward, let's go to 1 John, the second chapter. All right. 1 John, the second chapter, let us look at verses 24, first starting out. It says, "Let that therefore abide in you, which ye heard from the beginning. If that which ye have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, ye also shall continue in the Son and in the Father." And that couldn't be further from the truth, because Jesus, what he's talking about, and the Most High is talking about, is entirely two different things. Now, let us look at some of the writings of Jesus here, okay? Let's go to the book of Matthew. Matthew, the fifth chapter. Let us go there real quick. Matthew, the fifth chapter. And see what he's talking about here, okay? Matthew, the fifth chapter. All right. Now, we're going to look at a couple of verses in here. And like I say, just think about what Jesus says here. All right, Matthew, the fifth chapter, verses 21. Look what it says. It says, "Ye have heard that it was said by them of old." Talking about who? The prophets. Those that were of ancient time. The elders. This is who he's talking about. Now, look what he says. And he's, and see, let's get one thing straight. The elders, they only did the kings, the judges, all those who Yah had put in a area of being a ruler, if I may say, one that is ruling like a king, or in a high position. Whatever Yah told him to do, that's what they did. Now look what he says. He says, "Thou shalt not kill." But many of you know that have been following us. I talked about the scripture here on a couple of other occasions. Well, Yah told Israel to go in and kill everything that breathes, even the little babies. Kill everything. Don't let nothing come out. You know, kill everything that breathes. This is the God that I'm talking about. I'm not talking about no little play God like Jesus claimed. The God of the Hebrew Israelite, he is a terrible God. He's not one to be played with. All right, now, let's go a little further. He says, "And whosoever shall kill shall be in danger of judgment." Of who? When he told Israel to go in there and kill, God told him to go and kill. So who's going to judge him? If you see what I'm saying. But let's go a little further. Let's stay in the same chapter here. Let us jump down to verse 27. He says, "Ye have heard that it was said by them of old." See that? "Thou shalt not commit adultery." He says, "But I say unto you that whosoever looketh up on a woman and lusteth after her committed adultery with her already in his heart." Now, why would a so-called God say that if a man look upon a woman and lusteth after her? I mean, a man has to want a woman. I mean, there's only two figures here on this planet. You got male and you got female. Now, if he says that you can't look upon a woman to lust after her, who is he insinuating that you should look after? A man? Yes, because Jesus is a sissy. He's a sissy. That's why he put this writing in here. But anyway, let's go a little further, because we'll talk about that in another teaching. But look here, let us go to the book of Deuteronomy. You know, because we got to get back to, he's telling them to remember or what they had heard from the beginning. The beginning of what? The beginning of his ministry? Has to be. Because the Old Testament tells a totally different story. Let us go there. Deuteronomy, the 30th chapter. Let us go there. See what the Old Testament says. We're going to read a scripture out of here. And then we're going to leave. And then we're going to come back later on, okay? Because it's some more in here that I'm going to talk about. All right. Let us look at the 32nd chapter of Deuteronomy. Let's look at verses 7. Look what it says. It says, remember the days of old. Consider the years of many generations. Ask thy father, and he will show thee. See that? He said, ask thy father, and he will show thee. This is what Israel's supposed to do. But see, but after they stole us and brought us over here, and they killed off all the knowledge, then they could tell us anything. See what I'm saying, Israel? This is what God said. God says, all right, always go back to the elders. Go back to the old. But Jesus is telling you to remember what he said here in his teaching. Not to go back here. See, because if you go back here, then you'll see that this doesn't say what this says. I know that you may not quite understand what I'm saying right now, Israel, but once I get done, I'm gonna fasten it down where you're exactly where you will understand exactly what I'm saying. All right, now let us go back to the book of Isaiah. Now remember, now he says, remember the days of old. All right, let's go to Isaiah 46. Isaiah 46. Now we're gonna read a couple of scriptures out of here, and then we're gonna jump back down to 1 John. All right, Isaiah 46. Verse 9, look what it says here. It says, remember the former things of old. For I am God, and there is none else. I am God, and there is none like me. Okay, including Jesus now. Because now you see what Jesus is telling them to remember what he said. But he'll throw God's name in there to throw you off. But it mainly, he's telling you about you to remember what he said. But this is what God said. Remember the former things of old. See what I'm saying? Don't, no matter how far your life goes out there, or whatever, how far your generation go, always remember that which came from old. He says, for I am God. Don't forget that. And there is none else. Don't forget that. I am God, and there is none like me. Don't forget that. Don't ever forget that. Okay, this is etched in stone. Don't ever forget that, Israel. I don't care what you, I don't care you look to be 1,000 years. Don't ever deviate from this. All right, now let's go back to 1 John. Let's go to 1 John. I'm gonna show you something, Israel. Now I want you to think about the wording. Think about what we're talking about, and you'll see how stupid this is. Okay, now. 1 John 2, let's look at verse 25. All right, now watch this, Israel. It says, and this is the promise that he hath promised us. Okay, comma. Okay, hook. Now let's rest there for a minute. We're not going anywhere else until we find out what is this promise. What is this promise first? Is it that let this abide in you, which you have heard from the beginning? Is that what he's talking about? Is that the promise? But look at the hook there. Look what he said, even eternal life. That doesn't make sense at all. Why not let eternal life be all of it, and then you can scratch the rest of the BS? But look what he says here. He says, these things have I written unto you concerning them that seduce you. All right? Now, check this out right here, Israel. Look at the verse 27. It says, but the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you, and ye need not that any man teach you. Oh, stop. Stop the presses right now. Stop. Don't move. Don't move. Did y'all hear what he said? Did you Christians out here hear what he just said? He's saying the anointing that is already in you, you don't need no man to teach you anything. Okay, what you gonna do about your pastor? Not only that, what you gonna do about Jesus who was walking around? What you gonna do about Paul? What you gonna do about James? What you gonna do about John? You don't even need John. What you gonna do about Matthew and Luke? He said, you don't need any man to teach you, but as the same anointing teaches you all things. So in other words, you don't need Jesus either, because the anointing is going to teach you all things. Not only that, what about this so-called Holy Ghost? What about that individual? Huh? You don't need him either, because he says that this anointing teaches you all things and is true and is no lie. And even as it has taught you, ye shall abide in him. Look what he says here. Now, little children, abide in him, that when he shall appear, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. Why would you even put this statement in here? You already said that this anointing teach you anything, so how could you ever be ashamed? How could you not be ready? How could anything sneak up on you? This anointing here is teaching you all things. Not some things, all things. This is what it's saying. I'm not taking it out of any kind of context, if anybody wants to say that. It says he'll teach you all things, and it's true. And no lie. All right, now. Look what he says here. A latter part of 28. He says, may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. Now look at verse 29, my sisters and brothers. If ye know. What? If? Well, how about this anointing that teaches you all things? How can you say if? If ye know that. How? Why would it say if ye know that this anointing is teaching you all things? So you're supposed to know. This doesn't make any sense at all, my sisters and brothers. At all. Why would you use if? If ye know that he is righteous. The anointing is your teacher. He's teaching you all things about everything. So you should know this right here. So why we say, if ye know that he is righteous, ye know that everyone that doeth righteous is born of him. That makes no sense to me at all. Because that so-called anointing that supposedly is in you teaches you all things. But Israel, let's go a little further here. Let us look at verses. Let's go to Isaiah. Back to Isaiah. Isaiah 46. Watch this right here. Isaiah 46. Over there. Watch this right here, my sister and brother. Isaiah 46, 10. Look what it says. Declaring the end from the beginning. My sisters and brothers, are you with me? Did you hear what he said? Let's read again. Declaring the end from the beginning. Are you getting it, Israel? Let's say it again. Declaring the end from the beginning. The way that the New Testament is written, that you know what the end is over in Revelation. Couldn't be further from the truth. He says that you got to go to the end in order to find out what the beginning is. All right. In other words, the beginning will tell you the end. Am I right or wrong? I'm right. He says, and from ancient time, the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure. So what we got to do, in order for us to find out what the end is going to be, we got to flip it back and go back to the beginning. Yes. That's how you find out what the end is going to be. Because he says here, declaring the end from the beginning. So we got to flip it back to the beginning, and then we'll find out what the end is. Let's do that. Let's go back to the book of Deuteronomy. Okay, my sisters and brothers. Let's go to Deuteronomy 32. See, because we need to see how this thing works. Well, yeah, let's go to Deuteronomy 32. Let's look at this right here. We're going to read verse 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. All right? Now look what he says here. This is what the Most High wants Israel to remember. He says, remember the days of old. Consider the years of many generations. Ask thy father, and he will show thee. Thy elders, and they will tell thee. All right? Now look what he says here. When the Most High divided the nations, their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam. We're way back to the front now. See that? All right. He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. Listen to what he says now. Remember, we got to go back to the beginning to figure out what the end is going to be. It's right in the pages. Look what he says. For the Lord's portion is his people. Jacob is the lot of his inheritance. See that, my sisters and brothers? That's how you find out what the end is going to be. God doesn't change. I don't care what Jesus said. He grabbed there and he can sit one and say, God does not change. He ain't changed anything here. Look what he says. He says, in verse 10, he said, he found him in a desert land and in a wasted, hollow wilderness. He led him. Who? He. Not Jesus with him. He led him. Huh? About. He instructed him. God by himself. And I'm going to prove it. Jesus is nowhere with him. Jesus is nowhere with the Most High at any time. Look what he says here. He instructed him. Single. And he says, he kept him, not with Jesus, by himself, as the apple of his eye. Look what he says. He said, this is what I do for Israel. He said, as an eagle stirreth up her nest and fluttereth over her young, spreadeth abroad her wings, taketh them, band them on her wings. So the Lord, with Jesus or alone? So the Lord alone did lead him, and there was no strange God with him. End of story, my sisters and brothers. It's right in the pages. It's right in the pages. My sisters and brothers, it is not by accident that you and I have teamed up here at LightofMeNoMore.org. I have a love for God's people. I have a passion for what he have assigned me to do. I have never asked anyone for any funds, and I never will. I never want you to pay me for any of the lessons that we are here sharing with you, the word of the Most High, because the Most High instructed me several years ago that the secret things belong to the Lord. But those things that are revealed belong to the children. And I must reiterate, you know, once again, my sisters and brothers, there are those out there that wants you to get in ravel up with them and cahoots with them, and they're after your money. My sisters and brothers, God's word is free to the children. Don't get out there and get yourself messed up with these people that are trying to line their pockets and trying to advance themselves on your dime. God and his people, when God punished his people, we all went out in punishment together. God punished all of us together. Not one was up here and one was down here. No. If you go back and read the Old Testament, you will see every time God punished Israel, all of Israel was punished. So when we are cursed, when one is cursed, all of us are cursed. So don't let anyone fool you by asking you to join up, because it's all about getting in your pocket, my sisters and brothers. God is not like that. God is free. He said he's going to send you Elijah. So wait for Elijah. But anyway, my sisters and brothers, it is not by chance that we hooked up together here. I mean, I can look back at Joseph's plight, and Joseph's brothers, they did him wrong. Siblings, they wanted to kill him, you know, and they sold him and made a few nickels off of him. But I'm telling you, my plight from the South to where I'm now was not a pleasant one. I had situations. I had a state of mind. I had conditions that I was facing. And anyone that is called by the Most High, you're gonna have conditions that are not favorable in your side. You're gonna have a state of mind where you're gonna wonder whether God truly loves you because of the things that you are going to encounter. There are situations that you're gonna be placed in, which all were unfavorable, you know, concerning you. So, my sisters and brothers, what I'm saying here today is, I'm here teaching for the Most High, and it's not going to cost you anything. And like I said, if you look at Genesis chapter 50, verse 20, Joseph told them, he said, after everything was done, he said, you guys did it for evil, but God did it for good. And like I say, I am here only because of the Most High. He taken me from the South and brought me up north, you know, and doing my transitioning. You know, there was a lot of things that went on in my life that was unpleasant, but I'm still here. So my sisters and brothers, I'm going to do a video on my plight, and I'm hoping that it will shed some light on a lot of questions might be answered, you know, through the video, to inspire you to hold on, because God said he would never leave you. God would never leave you. Even though you may be struggling in some way, things may not be right, but the Most High, he will never leave you, as he never left Moses, nor Aaron, or any of the people that he called. Even though there were some tragic times in their lives, troublesome times in their lives, God was still with them. So my brothers, we here at LieToMeNoMore.org, we wish you a happy Sabbath. Until next time, shalom.